program of the online capacity building training for the resource persons of Samagra Siksha, Andhra Pradesh. And we are very happy to have Dr. Chandrika and Dr. Narasimham with us from Samagra Siksha, Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Chandrika Madam is the Deputy Director, as all of you know, from Samagra Siksha. And I would now request Chandrika Madam to give the opening remarks, and then we can start our webinar.
Ma'am, actually a small submission, Pulpa Madam.
Yes.
This is Dr. Narasimha. So ma'am, actually she come within 5 minutes, so it's better to start right now, ma'am, actually.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Narasimha. Once ma'am joins, you can ping us separately in WhatsApp, and sure, we will start.
Sure, madam. Sure, we will invite.
Okay. Thank you. As you all of you know, many of the participants know today's speakers are Dr. Jayanti Narayan and Dr. Nivedita Patnaik. And as you know, Dr. Jayanti Narayan Madam was the previously HOD in Department of Special Education, NIMH, then Deputy Director at NIMH, and she is very prominently involved in the rehabilitation of people with intellectual disabilities, learning disabilities. She's also a visiting professor in Northampton University, United Kingdom. So we are very glad, ma'am, that you have consented to be our today's speaker. Thank you so much. And I hope all the participants are going to benefit very richly from your today's talk. Yes. Over to you now, ma'am.
Good morning, everybody. Namaskaram and Yandarikum. I do not speak a very good Telugu, but I will manage to mix Telugu and English. I hope you don't mind that. I congratulate the state government for organizing this wonderful workshop to prepare our teachers for yet another challenge, that is home learning environment. Our teachers' roles are changing, and this is another new situation where they have to do the home learning environment and teaching children. Am I audible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I go ahead?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. ఇప్పుడు టీచర్ స్పెషల్ ఎడ్యుకేటర్స్ రోల్ మీరు చూసారంటే ఒక 50 సంవత్సరంగా చూస్తే ఫస్ట్ ఏమో స్పెషల్ స్కూల్స్ లో స్పెషల్ టీచర్స్ గా మనం ప్రిపేర్ చేసి పని చేశాము. So we were just looking after 5 to 10 children in special class. Then came inclusive education. ఇప్పుడు మీరందరూ ఒక కొత్త రోల్ లో ఇన్క్లూజివ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ లో పని చేస్తున్నారు. రెగ్యులర్ స్కూల్లో, రెగ్యులర్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో వెన్ వి ఇన్క్లూడ్ చిల్డ్రన్ విత్ డిసెబిలిటీస్ వాళ్ళకి ఎలాంటి సహాయం కావాలని చూసి మీరు రెగ్యులర్ టీచర్స్ తోటి పని చేస్తున్నారు. సో ఇన్క్లూజివ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇస్ టోటలీ డిఫరెంట్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ కంపేర్డ్ టు ద స్పెషల్ స్కూల్ అండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ వెరీ వెల్ అండ్ సో అవర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆర్ చిల్డ్రన్ విత్ డిసెబిలిటీస్ ఆర్ అచీవింగ్ ఆర్ రియలైజింగ్ ద రైట్ టు ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్ ద ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ అప్రోప్రియేట్ ఫార్ దెమ్. Then you also, when you do there, the tasks that you have in hand is to have your curriculum flexible, evaluation system flexible. ఇప్పుడు కొత్తగా యూనివర్సల్ డిజైన్ ఫర్ లెర్నింగ్ UDL అనేది మీకు తెలుస్తుంది. యూనివర్సల్ డిజైన్ అంటే అన్ని పిల్లలు డైవర్స్ లెర్నర్స్ ఒకే క్లాస్ లో ఉంటారు, మనం వాళ్ళకి లెసన్స్ ప్రిపేర్ చేసి ఒక్కొక్కరికి ఏది సూటబుల్ గా ఉంటుందో అది ఇవ్వాలనేది. సో we'll see it in a while, little bit more on universal design for learning. Red letters lo meeru ippudu chustunnaru mana very very new role that we are having, that is home learning of students with disabilities. So any avataram teeskuntam chudandi manam special educators, we have to be doing our best in each of the avatars that we are taking, and that is the challenge in front of us. ఇప్పుడు డిసేబుల్ చిల్డ్రన్ బాబుకి డౌన్ సిండ్రోమ్ ఉంది కాబట్టి అది చేయడం రాదు, బాబుకి హైడ్రోసెఫాలీ ఉంది ఇది చేయడం రాదు, బ్లైండ్ ఉందికి అది రాదు అనేది ఓల్డ్ మోడల్. అన్ని డెఫిసిట్ 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 అని చూసి డెఫిసిట్ కాబట్టి చెయ్యడు అని చెప్తే డెఫిసిట్ కు మ్యాగ్నిఫై చేస్తాం మనం పెద్దదిగా. ఇప్పుడు ప్రెసెంట్ మోడల్ ఏంటండి, డైవర్సిటీ ఉంటుంది అమంగ్ అస్, వీఆర్ ఆల్ డైవర్స్, వీఆర్ ఆల్ డిఫరెంట్ అండ్ ఈచ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ అస్ హావ్ డిఫరెంట్ స్టైల్ ఆఫ్ లెర్నింగ్. ఈ బాబీకి అది వస్తుంది, అది చేయగలదు, చేయగలదు, కానీ చూడడం ఒకటే కొంచెం కష్టం, తినబడం కొంచెం డిఫికల్టీ ఉంది. కాకపోతే కొంచెం మెల్లగా నేర్చుకుంటాడు ఐడి చూసారంటే అని. మీరు డిసబిలిటీకి ఒక సెకండరీ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఇస్తారు, బాబుది స్ట్రెంగ్త్ ఏముంది అనేది ప్రైమరీ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఇస్తారు. అదే డైవర్సిటీ ఫోకస్, వెన్ యూ లుక్ అట్ ద డైవర్సిటీ ఫోకస్ యూ గివ్ లెస్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆర్ లెస్ ఫోకస్ ఆన్ ద డిసెబిలిటీ, బట్ యూ గివ్ మోర్ ఫోకస్ ఆన్ ద చైల్డ్స్ ఎబిలిటీస్. ఎవ్రీ చైల్డ్ హ్యాస్ సమ్ ఎబిలిటీ ఆర్ ద అదర్, దర్ ఇస్ నో చైల్డ్ హూ ఇస్ హావింగ్ జీరో ఎబిలిటీ. మనం స్పెషల్ ఎడ్యుకేటర్స్ పని ఏంటండి, ఒక్కొక్క పిల్లకి ఎబిలిటీ ఏముంది, ఈవెన్ 5% ఎబిలిటీ ఉందంటే కూడా వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ ఎబిలిటీ, ఫైండ్ దట్ అవుట్, దాని మీద బిల్డ్ చేసి వాట్ ఈస్ రైట్ ఫర్ ద చైల్డ్ టు ట్రైన్, వి ట్రైన్. ఆటోమేటిక్ గా డిసబిలిటీ మీరు తక్కువ చూస్తారు, అప్పుడు ఎబిలిటీ ఎక్కువ చూస్తారు. ద హోల్ లైన్ ఆఫ్ థింకింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద టీచర్ చేంజెస్ వెన్ వి లుక్ అట్ ద చైల్డ్ యాజ్ అ చైల్డ్ విత్ అ డైవర్స్ లెర్నింగ్ నీడ్, నాట్ యాజ్ చైల్డ్ విత్ అ డెఫిసిట్ ఆర్ డిసెబిలిటీ. థింక్ ఫర్ అ మూమెంట్, చైల్డ్ విత్ అ డైవర్స్ లెర్నింగ్ నీడ్ యాజ్ అగేన్స్ట్ చైల్డ్ విత్ అ డెఫిసిట్ ఆర్ డిసెబిలిటీ, యువర్ కంప్లీట్ యాటిట్యూడ్ చేంజెస్. డిసెబిలిటీ బికమ్స్ అ మినిస్క్యూల్ థింగ్, abilities gets magnified as against the older system. So this is the first thing that we have to have in our mind when we work with children with disability, no matter what the environment of teaching is. Now intellectual disability chude ekwa mana focus enti, the three things, that is IQ will be low, adaptive behavior deficit, and if they should have had this condition before the age of 18. దానిలో అడాప్టివ్ బిహేవియర్ ఒకటి మన మేజర్ ఫోకస్ గా ఉంటుంది. వై? బికాస్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ కమ్స్ ఇన్ ద ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ లెర్నింగ్. కెపాసిటీ ఈస్ వన్ అండ్ హౌ యూ యాక్సెస్ ద చైల్డ్స్ కెపాసిటీ టు టీచ్ హిమ్ ఆర్ హర్ టు బ్రింగ్ ద బెస్ట్ అవుట్, ఫర్ దాట్ యువర్ ఫోకస్ ఇస్ ఆన్ అడాప్టివ్ బిహేవియర్. నాకు తెలుసు మెనీ టీచర్స్ మీకు ఎప్పుడు ఎక్కువ క్వశ్చన్, బిహేవియర్ ప్రాబ్లం ఉందండి మేడం ఏం చేయాలి, అట్లా చేశారు, ఇట్లా చేశారు, కూర్చోడు, అదన్నీ ఆల్ ద టైమ్ టీచర్స్ వరీస్ బిహేవియర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. బికాస్ దే సీ ద బిహేవియర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్, ద ఫోకస్ టెన్స్ ఆన్, ఐ మీన్ టెన్స్ టు బి ఆన్ రిడ్యూసింగ్ బిహేవియర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ రాదర్ దాన్ ఆన్ హౌ టు టీచ్. దట్ ఈస్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద డెఫిసిట్ ఇన్ దే అడాప్టివ్ బిహేవియర్. ఇప్పుడు లేటెస్ట్ డెఫినేషన్ చూసారంటే మీరు, the definitions of DSM as well as AIDD have focused on three areas. Anni curriculum da loplo vastundandi three areas, conceptual, so conceptual under that comes all your academic and academic learning, social has all your social and communication related things, and also to a great extent the child's emotional health, and practical takes care of the self-help skills, domestic skills, all those that you have to do every day to survive independent ka cheyadaniki. If it's a small baby, it's the basic motor and communication skills. Little older, then the various self-help skills. Adolescent, adult, then the domestic skills or pre-vocational skills. So all those are practical skills. So me complete curriculum chute idi under these three all will fit in. And the children with intellectual disability or the adults with intellectual disability tend to have deficits in these. Deficits in these obviously means it is, the behavior is not age appropriate or time appropriate or place appropriate. When these three, age, time and place, when a behavior is not appropriate, you call it as a deficit behavior or a maladaptive behavior. Take for example, age appropriate behavior, when you say there is a visitor to the house, let us say a visitor vacharu oka rendu samacharam babu unnadu, visitor vachina visitor emo biscuit ani istadu, babu రారా అని పిలుస్తారు బాబు కూర్చొని గోదిలో కూర్చుంటాడు బాబు ఇస్ ఇట్ అన్ అక్సెప్టబుల్ బిహేవియర్ ఎస్ బట్ ద సేమ్ బిహేవియర్ ద విజిటర్ కమ్స్ 10-year-old బాయ్ and then he gives him a biscuit he says come sit if he goes and sits on the lap it is not age appropriate behavior it's a deficit behavior definitely it is not age appropriate for that boy similarly taking when the whole city is sleeping somewhere in some one house you hear somebody taking a bath at 1:30 in the night it is not a time appropriate behavior you will wonder what it or a classroom is going on and you are teaching science let us say one person get excellent singer whenever you have a break time you get that singer to sing a song and all of you clap hands for the good singing but when you are teaching a science class this student gets up and starts singing in the science class is it a place appropriate behavior absolutely no you will see what went wrong the first thought that comes to your mind emaindi endiki ippudu paata padtaadu baba so any adaptive behavior you will put on these three scales age appropriate time appropriate place appropriate if it is not fitting in these three then you call it as an adaptive behavior deficit so whenever you work on a problem behavior please look at the context and now under conceptual all when you talk of a deficit behavior to be increased all the academics go under conceptual socio communication emotional ones go under the social and then the daily living skills of various ages and age appropriate skills to be independent as an adult independent living as a child it is the basic motor skills and language skills and all that as a school aged person it is a self help skill so all that have to be in order so do you see that the complete curriculum that you teach come under this one bit of concept that you are seeing in front of you now in a classroom when you say you are adapting the curriculum idi rendu chestaramma meeru okatemo accommodation inkokati modification rendu kalisi adaptation antunnamu accommodation ante enti curriculum atlane untundi teaching method lo meeru oka change iskostaru that will be appropriate to your student so the content will not change but you change your teaching process to suit the child so if it's a science lesson again let us say about parts of a plant cheppudappudu it is the same anni pillalu oka drawing chesi idi leaf idi stem idi roots idi flower ani raayagalaru ante mee class lo lesson remains the same If this child with intellectual disability maybe
option motor ikkada unde
it's not audible
no this one ppt is not visible
ppt is not moving
no it was not visible
from the beginning
no actually it was like cancel button yeah
it's like
Now they can see. Will you cross it? How will I? Yes ma'am, able to see the PowerPoint now.
రిపీట్ చేయాలా
వినబడలేదు నో మ్యామ్ సి యువర్ వాయిస్ వాస్ వెరీ క్లియర్ ద పిపిటి వాస్ నాట్ షోన్
కెన్ ఐ కంటిన్యూ
yes ma'am can continue now the powerpoint is also seen
can I continue okay so accommodation lo if there is a child with an intellectual disability maybe you will give him the plant real plant explain to him about the plant or take him to the garden all the children you can take to the garden and explain to them the leaf the plant the root the stem the flowers the fruit so this also you can show to him the real one and then names of it he copies when you have written maybe so this is method changes but content is the same modification ante enti, the content also changes and the method will also change. So you will reduce the curricular content. So for this boy, recognizing a plant as a plant, a tree as a tree, a small bush as a small bush, maybe that is where you will stop. You will not go into the finer details of it. So you are modifying the content completely to suit the need of the child. ఇప్పుడు చాలా మైల్డ్ ఇంటెలెక్చువలీ డిసేబుల్ పిల్లలు మీ క్లాస్ లో ఉన్నారంటే అకామిడేషన్ చాలు వాళ్ళకి. వేరస్ మోడరేట్ అండ్ సివియర్ స్పెషల్ స్కూల్ వాళ్ళు పిల్లలు అంటే మాడిఫికేషన్ మీకు అవసరం అవుతుంది. సో యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ద మాడిఫికేషన్ సూటబ్లీ. బట్ డోంట్ గో బై ద మైల్డ్ మోడరేట్ టైటిల్స్. గో బై ద చైల్డ్స్ ఎబిలిటీ బై అసెసింగ్ ద చైల్డ్ అండ్ దెన్ యూ డిసైడ్ ఓ మైల్డ్ అందుకే ఇట్లనే చేయాలి, మోడరేట్ అందుకే ఇట్లనే చేయాలి. నెవర్ 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 డూ ఇట్. ఎవ్రీ చైల్డ్ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్. సో అసెస్ ఈచ్ చైల్డ్ అండ్ అకార్డింగ్లీ యూ ఫస్ట్ ట్రై అకామిడేషన్. అకామిడేషన్ మీరు చేసి లాభం లేదు, బాబు ఏమో నేర్చుకోలేదు, కష్టపడతాడని ఉన్నారంటే అప్పుడు మీరు మాడిఫికేషన్ గురించి ఆలోచించాలి. సో డోంట్ రైట్ అవే సేమ్ moderate intellectual disability so modification cheyalani. Don't ever do it. Please always try what is closer to the regular curriculum. Ippudu home learning chesarante kuda the point is the same. Home learning or school learning, the point is the same. First you consider the existing curriculum, that is the regular school curriculum, and then the strength of the child and the needs of the child. Adi moodu interconnected. If you do not get one correct, all the others will also be affected. Therefore, make sure that all the three you take into consideration and then try giving the regular curriculum as it is. Otherwise, you will do the accommodation. If as it is not fitting, accommodation, the child is finding it frustrating, not able to learn, then go for modification. That will be the order in which you will think of adapting the curriculum. Home learning, lagapodi school learning, same. The principles don't change, Amma. Please remember, the principles of learning doesn't undergo change. The strategies don't undergo change. Places change and we adapt ourselves to suit the place where we are going to teach. Now, intellectually, when we talk about children with ID, మేజర్ ఫోకస్ మీకు ఎక్కడ ఉంటుందంటే ఆర్ ది అటెండింగ్. మనము టీచ్ చేసేటప్పుడు అటెండ్ చేస్తూ ఉన్నారా? అటెండ్ చేస్తారు కానీ అది అర్థం చేసుకొని దాని మీద థింకింగ్ చేయలేదు అంటే యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఆల్సో ఇంప్రూవ్ దేర్ థింకింగ్ కెపాసిటీ. అటెండ్ చేశాడు, థింకింగ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ జరిగింది అంటే దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు మేక్ షూర్ వెదర్ హీ ఈజ్ ఏబుల్ టు keep it in his memory. ela test chestaru meer adugutaru emi ippudu nerpicharo adi gurinchi meer questions adigithe babu to response correct ga vachindante that means verbal response or written response depending upon the child's ability level, then you know his memory is taking it and storing it. Memory lo kuda meer ee roju nerpichi ee roju adugithe jawab istaru shayad. రేపు మీరు అడిగితే మర్చిపోతాడు. అంటే ఏంటి, ఇమీడియట్ మెమరీ మంచిగా ఉంది, డిలేడ్ రీకాల్ అంత మంచిగా లేదు అనేది మీ అనుమానం అవుతుంది. అప్పుడు దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు ఇంప్రూవ్ ఆన్ ద చైల్డ్స్ డిలేడ్ రీకాల్ కెపాసిటీస్ బై రిపీటెడ్ టీచింగ్. బట్ యువర్ ఫోకస్ వైల్ టీచింగ్ ద త్రీ థింగ్స్ యూ విల్ మేక్ షూర్ హ్యాపనింగ్. వన్ ఇస్ దట్ ద చైల్డ్ ఇస్ అటెండింగ్, టూ ద చైల్డ్ ఇస్ థింకింగ్ అండ్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ వాట్ or teaching him or showing him or making him experience, and three adi nechukuna tarvata store chestuntadu manchiga, it goes and stores in his brain. And ippudu ventane reply ichchadu gaani repu nenu adiginappudu ee reply iyaledante, two things about memory. One, immediate memory is good but delayed recall is not good. Repu kuda manchigane jawab icharante very good, go to the next level, happy situation there. Okay, so based on this, you adjust the content without losing the main idea and restructure your teaching. This may be special school, this may be inclusive school, this may be home learning. Principles are the same. I'm repeatedly saying the same thing. ఇప్పుడు ఇది మీకు ఫెమిలియర్ గా ఉంటుంది, అందరూ బిఎడ్ చేశారు కదా, అక్విజిషన్ మెయింటెనెన్స్ ఫ్లూరెన్సీ జనరలైజేషన్. ఇప్పుడు మీ టాస్క్ ఏంటంటే యాజ్ ఎ టీచర్ మీరు యాజ్ ఎ స్టూడెంట్ వెన్ యూ లెర్న్ ఆల్సో మీకు ఒక అక్విజిషన్ స్టేజ్ ఉండింది. ఎవ్రీ లెర్నింగ్ హాస్ అన్ అక్విజిషన్ స్టేజ్. నెక్స్ట్ మీకు కూడా ఒక మెయింటెనెన్స్ స్టేజ్ ఉండింది. ఫ్లూయెన్సీ ఈజ్ వెన్ యూ డూ ఇట్ విత్ ఈజ్, యు నో, వెన్ ఆటోమేటికలీ విత్ ప్రొఫిషియన్సీ అండ్ ఈజ్. జనరలైజేషన్ ఈజ్ యువర్ ఎబిలిటీ టు టేక్ ఇట్ ఫార్వర్డ్ టు ఎనీ గివన్ సిట్యువేషన్. మీరు వాట్ కెన్ ఐ టేక్ అస్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, సైక్లింగ్. సైక్లింగ్ చేస్తారా మీరు? ఫస్ట్ సైక్లింగ్ నేర్చుకున్నప్పుడు థింక్ అబౌట్ ఇట్, సంబడి వాజ్ హోల్డింగ్ యూ, సో యూ కుడ్ రైడ్ ద బైక్. దట్ ఈస్ అ ఫిజికల్ ప్రాంప్ట్ ఇనిషియలీ, దెన్ ప్రాబబ్లీ అకేషనల్ వర్బల్ ప్రాంప్ట్, అండ్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ గా మీరు మెల్లమెల్లగా చేసేటప్పుడు అక్కడ దూరంగా ఒక వెహికల్ వస్తే ఇక్కడ మీకు రెస్ట్లెస్ అవుతారు మీరు, రైట్? దెన్ దట్ ఈస్ అక్విజిషన్ ఫేజ్. ఎనీ లెర్నింగ్, హెయిర్ బ్రైడింగ్ ఫర్ ఇన్స్టెన్స్, ఫస్ట్ మీరు చేసినప్పుడు అక్విజిషన్ ఫేజ్. సరిగా రాదు, సంబడి ఈస్ హెల్పింగ్ యూ. ఇప్పుడు రోజు చేస్తున్నారు మీరు, మీకు యూ డోంట్ ఈవెన్ థింక్ యూ ఆర్ బ్రైడింగ్, ఇట్ ఆటోమేటికలీ ఇట్ హ్యాపన్స్. యూ రైడ్ యువర్ స్కూటర్, ఆటోమేటికలీ ఇట్ హ్యాపన్స్. And even if your mind is thinking something else, if you see a red light or some obstacle on the way, suddenly your leg goes for the brake. You don't think about it. So that is fluency. You see, acquisition is when your whole learning process happens. Repeated practices maintenance. అది వచ్చిన తర్వాత విత్ స్పీడ్ అండ్ ఈజ్, ఒకే టైంలో రెండు కూడా మీరు చేయగలరు. మూడు డిఫరెంట్ థింగ్స్ యూ కెన్ డూ ఫ్లూయెన్సీ విత్ ఈజ్. ద లాస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ if you have learned to let us say ride a one kind of a scooter, tomorrow you are given another kind of a scooter, you are able to ride that scooter is generalizing. Or you are familiar in riding in one route with your scooter, and tomorrow you are asked to go on another route for some purchases, and the new route you are taking with the scooter, it is generalization. So currently meeku మన ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చూసుకుంటే, COVID-19 సిట్యుయేషన్ వచ్చింది, యువర్ ఆల్ స్పెషల్ టీచర్స్ రెగ్యులర్ స్కూల్లో కొంతమంది పనిచేశారు, ఇప్పుడు ఐ మీన్ స్పెషల్ స్కూల్లో చేశారు, ఇప్పుడు రెగ్యులర్ స్కూల్లో ఇంక్లూసివ్ టీచర్స్ గా ఉన్నారు. ఇప్పుడు థర్డ్, అది రెండు మీరు జనరలైజ్ చేశారు. రెగ్యులర్ స్కూల్లో, స్పెషల్ స్కూల్లో హౌ టు టీచ్ ఈజ్ వాట్ వాజ్ టాట్ టు యూ ఇన్ యువర్ బిఎడ్ యాజ్ అ లార్జ్ చంక్ అండ్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఆఫ్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ ద regular schools also, right? But you are able to shift from your special school environment, generalize it to your regular school environment. That is your generalization. Now you are going to change yourself to work in a home learning situation, the third kind of generalization of your own skill. Artham avutundi kada andi? It is your own skill. You are general, the skill doesn't undergo change. The acquisition maintenance, all that happened doesn't undergo change. The situation changes based on which you are using the learned skills in the given new situation. As you are doing that, the reinforcements also will be more in the acquisition phase. During the maintenance phase, the reinforcement reduces. The support also will reduce. The physical prompt becomes a verbal prompt, and then the occasional cues and fades. Fluency or proficiency, you do it with speed and ease. Maybe no reinforcement at all will be given to the child. A generalization, when you go to a new environment, you are all now little anxious about home learning, ఎలా చేస్తాను చేయలేదు కదా ఇప్పుడు వరకు, ఫస్ట్ టైం. సో ఇనిషియలీ ఎనీ జనరలైజేషన్ ఫేజ్ విల్ హ్యావ్ అ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ యాంగ్జైటీ, డోంట్ వరీ అబౌట్ ఇట్. బేసిక్ స్కిల్స్ ఆర్ ద సేమ్, వాట్ యూ హ్యావ్ లెర్న్డ్ ఇస్ ద సేమ్, యూ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు అప్లై ఇట్ ఇన్ అ డిఫరెంట్ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్, ద సేమ్ థింగ్ అప్లైస్. మీ టీచర్స్ ఒక ఎగ్జాంపుల్ గా తీసుకొని నేను ఇప్పుడు చెప్పినది, మన పిల్లలకి కూడా సేమ్ థింగ్ అప్లైస్. Anything that you want to teach, you adapt it to the newer environment. To do that, you are using these principles. You are very familiar with this: shaping, chaining, modeling, prompting and fading, contingency, contracting, token economy. All these are the things that you continue to use. Now, I find when I go for RCI interview, RCI is inspections and all, some places, anywhere in India when I go, some places I find teachers are not having a clarity on the meaning of shaping as against when to use shaping, when to use the, what is chaining, what is a backward chain, what is a prompt. Yes, teachers are very comfortable with what is a physical prompt, a verbal prompt, occasional cues, yes, but little bit of difficulty. Shaping lo em chudalantama, first thing is the reinforcement, when to give the reinforcement. That is the key factor in shaping. When to give the reinforcement. Oka task nerpiyalante, first meeru task analysis chesi pettukuntaru kada. So first when you have to give the reinforcement, let us take an example of now. COVID-19 situation lo, mana medical advice, the hygiene advice is that vegetables anni meer konni teeskochina ventane first konchi sepu bar petteyandi, outside petteyandi anedi. Then take out the vegetables, onions or garlic chodke, the rest of the vegetables okka drop soap water lo oka bucket lo petti vegetables anni petteyandi, oka drop of hand wash soap water lo put all the vegetables, leave it for about 15-20 minutes. Then in another bucket of good water, wash vegetables, change the water, wash vegetables and put it on a drain pan. Bartan saaf chesi pettam kada oka tokri, danlo vegetables anni petti drain, water has to drain and go away, and then put it in your containers to put in the refrigerator. Anukondi idi meeru nerpistaru at home for a child with the intellectual disability. ఫస్ట్ డే వెజిటబుల్ అన్ని వచ్చిన తర్వాత మీరు బాల్కనీలోనో ఓపెన్ స్పేస్ లోనో పెడతారు. ఫస్ట్ డే అదన్నీ మీకు తీసుకువచ్చి లోపల పెట్టడానికి బాబు హెల్ప్ చేశాడంటే యూ రీఇన్ఫోర్స్, షబాస్ మంచిగా చేశావు. నెక్స్ట్ డే సోప్ వాటర్ లో వెజిటబుల్స్ తీసి అనియన్స్ గార్లిక్ బయట పెట్టి బాకీ అన్ని తీసి అన్ని వెజిటబుల్స్ మీ పెట్టిన సోప్ వాటర్ లో బాబు పెడతాడు. మీరు లోపల వెజిటబుల్ తీసుకువచ్చినందుకు ఈ రోజు రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ ఇయరు, సోప్ వాటర్ లో పెట్టిన తర్వాతనే రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ ఇస్తారు సెకండ్ టైం. థర్డ్ టైం ద ఫస్ట్ టూ, బ్రింగింగ్ ద వెజిటబుల్స్ ఇన్ సైడ్ పుట్టింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ సోప్ వాటర్ గెట్స్ నో రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్, బట్ టేకింగ్ ఇట్ అవుట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సోప్ వాటర్ అండ్ పుట్టింగ్ ఇన్ ద క్లీన్ వాటర్ ఓన్లీ విల్ గెట్ ద రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్. దట్స్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ సక్సెసివ్ అప్రాక్సిమేషన్స్ టువర్డ్స్ యువర్ గోల్, టువర్డ్స్ యువర్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్. The next day, wash it and then put it in the drying tokri, drying basket. So the first step of bringing vegetables, not reinforced. Putting in soap water, not reinforced. Putting in clean water, not reinforced. But putting in the tokri, in the bigger basket to dry, only gets reinforced. So each time when the child moves to the next step, only the reinforcement is given. This is called shaping. So చూడండి దానిలో ఏం ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఏంటి, ఎప్పుడు మీరు రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ ఇస్తున్నారు, దట్ ఈస్ ద కీ ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఇన్ షేపింగ్. అండ్ ఇట్ హెస్ గాట్ టు బి సక్సెసివ్ అప్రాక్సిమేషన్, అంటే ఏంటి, క్లోజర్ టు ద యాక్చువల్ గోల్. సక్సెసివ్ అప్రాక్సిమేషన్ ఈస్ క్లోజర్ టు ద యాక్చువల్ గోల్. యాక్చువల్ గోల్ ఇస్ ద టాస్క్ మీరు చేసి పెట్టినారు అక్కడ, హీ విల్ బ్రింగ్ ద వెజిటబుల్స్ ఇన్ సైడ్, వాష్ దమ్ in soap and ordinary water, dry them, put it in the respective containers and put it inside the refrigerator or the whatever place. Ani oka big task undante idanni analysis lo first step, first day gets reinforcement, second day first step does not get, but only second step will get, then the third, then the fourth. So finally complete task only will get the reinforcement on the final day, not in between steps. మేబీ మధ్య మధ్యలో మీరు ప్రాంప్ట్స్ ఇవ్వగలరు, హీస్ ఫర్గెటింగ్ సంథింగ్ సో యు ఆర్ ప్రాంప్టింగ్ హిమ్, ఇట్స్ ఫైన్. ఇన్ షేపింగ్ యూ కెన్ యూస్ ప్రాంప్ట్స్, నో ప్రాబ్లమ్, రైట్? బట్ యు హావ్ గాట్ టు బి వెరీ కేర్ఫుల్ ఇన్ అప్రిసియేషన్, ప్రొవైడింగ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇస్ అప్రోప్రియేట్ టు ద చైల్డ్ అప్రిసియేషన్. సో సమ్ వర్బల్ ప్రాంప్ట్ యూ మే బి గివింగ్, యూ ఆర్ స్టాండింగ్ అండ్ వాచింగ్, హీఈస్ డూయింగ్ అ మిస్టేక్, హీఈస్ ట్రైంగ్ టు పుట్ ద అనియన్ ఇన్ ద వాటర్. వద్దు బాబు అనియన్ పెట్టమా, అనియన్ బయట పెట్టు అంటే దట్స్ అ వర్బల్ ప్రాంప్ట్. అనియన్ నీళ్ళు పెడతావా అని అడిగితే అది క్యూ, ఎందుకంటే బాబు థింక్ చేసి అనియన్ నీళ్ళు పెట్టకు బయట పెట్టాలి అనేది విల్ కమ్ ఫ్రమ్ హిస్ ఓన్ థింకింగ్. So that becomes an occasional cue, or whenever the cue has to be given. So within shaping, you can use this. Within shaping, you can use modeling. Then chestanu chudu babu ilanti repu nu cheyali sarna nenu potato chestanu ni atlane bindi cheyi adi kuda cheyochu adi modeling ela nenu neello pettunanu chudu potatoes nenu chesina tarvata nanni chusi ni bindi ani atlane tomatoes ani atlane pettu ante that becomes modeling. So within shaping you may use many many other strategies, but the key factor here is to do with the reinforcements, right? So now we'll look at chaining. So it's a series or sequence of behaviors. First, you would have done the task analysis for it. And almost all academic skills, meeku Shilpa madam cheptunnaru kada, easy to difficult, known to unknown. So you always go from easy to difficult, simple to complex. So forward chaining only you will use for academics, because you are organizing them easy to difficult. Most of the time it will only be forward chain, because the decision is in your hand as a teacher. Easy first teach chesi tarvata difficulties chestam ante easy steps modata pettam on top of it, and then comes a difficult step. Backward chains usually we use on most of many of the self help daily living activities, where the activity itself has a combination of easy and difficult steps mixed into it. Like if you take toothbrushing for instance, brush meeda paste pettadam chala kashtam, adi first step gaani chala kashtam, petti iste doing the teeth is easy step. So difficult step can come first and easy step can come later. There many a time you can use the backward chaining. ఇప్పుడు నేను ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇస్తాను, దాంట్లో ఒక అకాడమిక్ రిలేటెడ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్ చైనింగ్ కూడా ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇస్తున్నాను చూడండి. సో దిస్ ఇస్ అ ఫార్వర్డ్ చైనింగ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. సీ ద డిఫికల్టీ లెవెల్. ఫస్ట్ రీడ్, దిస్ ఇస్ అ ట్రీ. సో నెక్స్ట్ ద చైల్డ్ హ్యాస్ టు ఫిల్ ఇన్ ద బ్లాంక్. దిస్ ఇస్ అ బిగ్. హీ హ్యాస్ టు థింక్ బిగ్ వాట్ ట్రీ. ట్రీ ఎండ్ స్పెల్లింగ్ మీద లైన్ లో ఉంది. హీ కెన్ లుక్ అట్ ఇట్ అండ్ హీ కెన్ రైట్ దట్. సో ఇట్ ఇస్ slightly difficult than the first one. And the third one, the color of the leaves are on the, again the tree, right? So he can copy it, or 2-3 times writing he may get the spelling by himself also. He is, and he has to look at the picture and think. Critical thinking is something children with intellectual disability lack. Remember that critical thinking varku takwa undi. But you have to give activities where they can think, they have to think and respond. So this is slightly more difficult than the second step. The tree is easy, color on the leaves of the color of the leaves on the tree is, then look at the picture, then relate it to the color green, then get the spelling for green. So a little more difficult. The color of the sky behind, again two dashes, he has to fill that. And again, it's another color that is coming there. The tree word is becoming more easy because of maintenance. It will end up in fluency very soon, because the tree comes everywhere. One other new word adds. See how the forward chaining difficulty level is getting increased in this. The color of the grass near the tree is, he has to write that again. The green comes two times in it. One. On the tree and again the grass. Now the last one, do you like to draw a picture of a tree? Yes. And then there are five dashes in fact, and all the dashes he can fill by getting words from the text above itself. He doesn't have to think on his own. Yes. I like he can get from the previous line. Two. Then he has to think of the word draw, then look at the spelling there and write. A is given. Picture he has to copy. A tree he has to copy. So the difficulty level has gradually become more, and the responses are inbuilt in the passage you have given. He doesn't have to look for it. Except for the spelling for green and blue, almost all is inbuilt that he will be able to get it. This is a forward chain where you go from the first step to the last step, where he writes the more number of blanks. The last sentence will be without any clue given. He has to write the whole sentence on his own. That will be your final step. So this is a very neatly done forward chain. So we look at the backward chain. I'm trying to do it with academics so that you will understand. The task you have given to the child is draw on color pictures using three different colors. The last point, what you see is draws the outline, selects the correct color and colors fully. That is what you want to achieve. When you do the backward chaining, you do the last bit first, and then the second last and the third last and the fourth last and the fifth last. So look at this now. The teacher does everything. Outline drawing teacher chestundi, two colors also teacher chestunnaru. Then the teacher says, picture chudu, rendu colors nenu chesi pettanu, inkoka color okkati nenu cheyaledu kada, ye color ani chusi nuvu ai color cheyamani. So probably the first one the teacher even will hand over the color, color it, watch the picture and color it. So he's doing the last step of finishing the picture. Last step of finishing the picture is done by the student. And the next one, if you see, the teacher colors one segment and then asks the outline given one segment. Now the student has to color two segments of it. So last time he did only one finishing. Now he has to do two bits to finish it. And the third level, the teacher provides outline, all the colors he has to do. So closer to the final picture, but all the three colors he has to do. Fourth step, outline kuda bavve cheyali, filling in colors also he has to do. So all the colors he tends to do. So the backward chaining is when almost finished, one step alone the student does, and then the number of steps completed by an adult. Home environment lo adult to sibling or grandparent everyone undochu. So they do most of it and then the child does the last one. Meeku cooking telsandi, cooking telsandi, mee amma meeku nerpichedu gurtu pettukondi. Anni petti fire meeda untappudu gas 5 whistle aina tarvata gas band cheyi anedi first meeku nerpicharu mee amma. Gas band pettu, last step of cooking. And then milk she puts on the fire. Adi meedu vachinappudu gas band pettu, fire band cheyi. Close the fire when the milk comes up. Last step first. That's how you learnt also many tasks. Last step first. Then she says, oh, put the milk in the vessel and then put it on the fire. I will light the gas. So mother will light the gas. You will only see that the milk comes up and you put off the fire. Similarly, cooking, you may help with the cutting the vegetables and all of that, putting it on the fire and taking out. She may taking out. What do you call this? Is it cooked? To check whether it is cooked, your mother tells you. Adi sabji avutundi, adi cooking ainda ani chudi chusi band cheyi. So last step, and then the second last step, it should be cooked before you put it off. Finally, she taught you to put the mirch masala, right? So that is a beautiful backward chain. Questions are you can't do it now. I'll finish it and take the questions together. Is it okay? Yeah. So looks like there are some questions. I'll just finish this few more and then I'll take the questions together. Where are the questions? So there's a little bit of technology difficulty here to go back and come back. So can I take it later? How to assess LD and all doesn't come here.
Yes, ma'am, you can take the questions later.
Yeah, because the flow will go on this system itself. I'm not seeing them parallelly on my side. So the question answer is not visible to me.
No, no, ma'am. It's okay. You can take the questions later. No issues.
And also it is... I have to hurry because of the next speaker waiting.
Sure,
but the
sure.
Okay. I want to get straight so that home learning doesn't become a scary thing for the teachers.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So modeling, I spoke to you about, it could be used alongside. So what you have to watch during modeling is make sure the child is attending when you are doing an act, even for that vegetable issue that I was talking to you about, you meer chesi chupiste babu, he the child looks at you and does it. So modeling can go alongside. You do it, stand back and watch, let the child do. So చూసినది గుర్తు పెట్టుకోవాలి. సో అటెన్షన్ తర్వాత రిటెన్షన్, రిటెన్షన్ తర్వాత మోటారిక్ రిప్రొడక్షన్. హీ హాస్ టు డూ ఇట్ అండ్ షో వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ డిడ్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ, హీ హాస్ టు డూ ఇట్ అండ్ షో. అండ్ దెన్ యూ మే నాట్ డూ ఇట్ అగైన్ బట్ ద చైల్డ్ విల్ డూ ద ఇండిపెండెంట్ డూయింగ్ అండ్ యూ మే గివ్ గైడెడ్ ప్రాక్టీస్. ఇది ఇట్లా చేయాలి, ఇది అట్లా చేయాలి, లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ గైడెడ్ ప్రాక్టీస్ అండ్ వేర్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్ యూ విల్ గివ్ అ కరెక్టివ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్. సో దిస్ ఆల్సో కెన్ బి యూస్డ్ beautifully in home environment where you can model for the mothers or the grandparents. Grandparents, I'm telling you, they are excellent resource persons for you to train. Intlo grandparents unnarante suddenly they start to feel a purpose in their life when you give them importance and tell you are going to train this child, nenu chupistanu, and their modeling works very very well for you to show to the grandparents, elder siblings, whoever is at home. And in my experience, I have seen the maids in the house who they have appointed particularly to take care of this child with ID. They have become my excellent teachers, in fact. I show them, they pick up skills very fast and then they work with the child and improve. They are not highly educated, as you know. But then these strategies, if we give them the clue, then they pick up and they are able to do it. So when home learning, don't just look at parents. Please look at what are all the resources available in the house and use any of those resources to transfer these strategies that you are seeing now. This all of you know, so I'm going to skip, because all teachers generally do excellently well. What is a natural prompt? I would like to tell you, natural prompt is what a child sees and picks up. You go to a library or some place, let us say, and normally we walk with slippers inside the library, but in this particular library outside there is no board, but there are a lot of slippers kept outside. That's a natural prompt, that you want to leave your slippers outside and go in. There is no board saying leave your slippers here, there is nothing like that, but you see all slippers kept in a line, you tend to leave it. Similarly, you loudly you are talking with your friends and walking, and you are entering a corridor where you turn to your right and looks like everybody is writing and there is one person walking up and down. So some examination is going on here and they have not cordoned off, so I have to be silent. So natural prompt that you go silent because there is a class going on next door and you cannot be loud. So these are natural prompt you and I pick up because we have the cognitive capacity. Children with intellectual disabilities need to be taught because of their limited cognitive capacity, right? So the other prompts you are very good at it. So I'm going to skip this. And I told you about universal design for learning. So intlo kuda meeru universal design simply means use many many methods to teach, use many many methods for the allow the child to respond back to you in many many methods. Whatever he cannot always written answers, he can put it in a form of a story, he can give you one word answers verbally, he can do it and show you. So expression, allow the child to have different ways of expression. Third, equally important, child ka challenge level ela shaping lo chusam kada, only when he does a task well, the same task doesn't get appreciated, but the next level only gets appreciated. Here also, whichever is challenging enough to the child, only you give him those activities. Manchiga chestunnadu ante adhe mari 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 isthe labham emi undadu. Manchiga chestunnadu ante we have to go to the next level. And these are the three principles to use in UDL. Many many ways of teaching, many many allowing the child to express in many many ways, each child look at the challenge level, and then you make sure that you give activity that is challenging to him, otherwise he'll get bored. If it is too easy, he gets bored. Problem behavior, you know, pakka vallu pinchadam kottadam all that, because it is not interesting, boring for him. Or you give him very very high అర్థం కాలేదు నాకు ఏమో ఇచ్చారు టీచర్ ఎక్కడెక్కడ చూస్తాడు హీ ప్రాబ్లమ్ బిహేవియర్ స్టార్ట్స్ సో ద ఛాలెంజ్ లెవెల్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ బై అప్రోప్రియేట్ అసెస్మెంట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ సో వెన్ యూ ప్లాన్ ద ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ దట్ యూ విల్ కీప్ ఇన్ మైండ్ ఇస్ ద బ్రాడ్ పిక్చర్ అన్ని పిల్లలకి నేర్పించాలంటే ఒక ప్లాన్ చేస్తే ఇప్పుడు 5 హోమ్ విజిట్స్ ఉంది అని అనుకోండి మీరు All the 5 children, I want to teach this in 5 different homes. What all of them will learn? Take activities that can be common for all of them. 5 different homes, all right. But your planning can be common. Right? And out of the 5, 3 children will learn this, 2 cannot learn. That is the second level. And this is only for this child. Other children don't need this. That's the top level. So when you plan, you have individual assessments done, individual program planning done. From among that, pick up the common ones that makes the base. And then little more specific and then very, very specific. This way, when you plan, you don't get overwhelmed with the many children in many current levels. Oh my God, how will I do? You know, that situation will not come. I know teachers are the most stressed people, special teachers. Because of the various levels of children with disabilities you work with regular teachers, you work with school principals, you go from house to house. And I really, and then nowadays you work on WhatsApp and you know the system linked things is also a challenge now that all of you are working very well. I being a special teacher, I very well know what a difficult task it is for special teachers. But these are little clues I'm giving you that makes your life easy. So look at individual assessment and from individual assessment, select out the common ones that you can teach all of them. So your day's planning becomes easy. Yeah? And you'll have to do a lot of adaptations. So reduce or increase time, reduce or increase the size of the content you are going to teach. Reduce or increase the level of help you are providing to the child. Work on the input, how much you are going to give the child. Maybe all children get a full lesson, this child may get a quarter of a lesson. Alternate with the new lesson modification, as I told you earlier. Adjust the difficulty level, make it a little easier for him. Output, allow him to say verbally when other children are doing writing work. So at home, you see there are certain support systems, use them and then put it into the adaptation for you and allow everybody to participate. Even pets in the house are resources for you. If there are pets in the house, there are ways of using it. So this is what you would do. And lastly, these are all the various strategies, techniques you will use. Activity-based learning, differentiated instructions, the earlier circle that you see, this is nothing but differentiated instruction. Each child gets his own time allotted, his own size of content you are giving, level of help, input. This is all you differentiate from child to child. It's not common for all. Yeah. Then accommodate or modify, we have seen that. Team teaching, aapke saath, one more person, mother can become another teacher with you. The sibling, elder sibling can become a teacher with you. So team teaching at home. Or dual teaching, it means the same almost. Evaluation and replanning and continuous CCE, you are very familiar with, and also the cooperative learning techniques where you collect the family members together and do like games. Next session, madam will also show you some of the games, how to use the token economy, all those things she will be able to tell you also where there will be a cooperative learning environment at home. Not necessarily classroom and project will have cooperative learning. Everywhere there can be cooperative learning. So never give up. Every child will learn. No child is, he can't do anything. You as a special teacher, I as a special teacher, we should never give up on a child saying, I can't do anything with him or he can't learn anything. There is no such situation. Take this seriously. And now we'll take the questions. Help me, Sudhakar, the questions. Very good. No, there are some boxes.
Good afternoon.
There are some questions in the...
Good afternoon, madam.
Are you talking to me, Nibedita?
Yes, madam.
Tell me.
There are some questions from the participants. One very basic thing, some Shehnaz has asked, how to assess LD students in inclusive setup? Probably that was not the topic, but if you can throw some light.
Inclusive setup or home learning setup, the tests have to be used. The various, the child, we have to first know in what class he's attending, right? And then what makes you think he is ALD. So first of all, we have to see what class he is attending. Second, we have to ensure that the child is not having intellectual disability, vision impairment, hearing impairment, socio-emotional issues, all that has to be ruled out, right? And then, ఐదు క్లాస్ లో కూర్చుంటాడంటే బాబు ఐదు క్లాస్ లెవెల్ ఫంక్షన్ చేయలేదంటే మీరు క్లాస్ వన్ లెవెల్ టెస్ట్ ఇవ్వండి, లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ అండ్ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్. పాస్ చేసాడంటే క్లాస్ టూ లెవెల్, మీ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ నుంచి మీరు క్వశ్చన్ తీసుకోవచ్చు. క్లాస్ టూ లెవెల్, క్లాస్ త్రీ లెవెల్, ఏ క్లాస్ లెవెల్ ఫెయిల్ అవుతారని చూడండి మీరు. సో మేబీ మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ హీస్ డూయింగ్ క్లాస్ త్రీ లెవెల్ అండ్ క్లాస్ ఫోర్ లెవెల్, whereas language lo class 2 level lo fail ayinadante he is likely to be functioning in that. This is the educational assessment, this is not diagnostic assessment. So educational assessment lo first I repeat, whatever class he is sitting, look at his scorecards. So what is his scorecard, his progress report, and then you look at the child's other disability, rule out the other disability, no hearing impairment, no vision impairment, no intellectual disability, no socio-emotional problems, good teaching. Good teaching is very, very important. With all that, he is functioning below average, then you will give him tests at various levels. One other thing you can do, look at his notebooks. Dano ekwa reversals undi, omissions undi, alanti oka pattern kanapadindante, he is likely LD, but you have to pitch him what level he is working. So, you will give tests suitably. Yeah?
Yes. Thank you, madam. I think some of them wanted in Telugu, which may not be possible. Another important question somebody has asked.
What question?
For the students with severe and profound disability, personal skills, how it can be taught?
Severe and profound disability?
Personal skills, how it can be taught?
Strategies, adhi kada, manam ipde cheppinamu. Strategies, same strategies ne manam use cheyali gaani, vaaldi progress mellaga jarugutadi. And ఫిజికల్ ప్రాంప్ట్ లెవెల్ ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది కొన్నిసేపు. సెకండ్, అడాప్టివ్ మెటీరియల్స్ కావాలని ఉంటూ ఉంది. సివియర్ ప్రొఫౌండ్ అంటే ఒక సైకలాజికల్ టర్మ్, దానిలో మనకు ఎక్కువ డోంట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఎనీథింగ్. అదే ఎగ్జాక్ట్ కరెంట్ లెవెల్ మీరు చెప్తే కూర్చోగలడు కానీ నడవడం రాదు, ఆర్ ఫుడ్ హీ డజన్ చూ అండ్ స్వాలో బట్ అట్లనే మింగుతున్నాడు అని స్పెసిఫిక్ కరెంట్ లెవెల్ మీరు చెప్తే దానికి మనం ఎగ్జాక్ట్ టీచింగ్ స్ట్రాటజీస్ ప్లాన్ చేయగలం. సివియర్ ప్రొఫౌండ్ మైల్డ్ మోడరేట్ అని బట్టి లెసన్ ప్లాన్ జరగదు, ఇంపాసిబుల్ టు డూ దాట్. సో వీ నీడ్ టు వెరీ క్లియర్లీ నో ద కరెంట్ లెవెల్. దెన్ ఆల్ దీస్ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్, ఇప్పుడు ఏది నేను చెప్పిన సేమ్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ లెవెల్ చూసి మీరు ప్లానింగ్ చేయాలి. ఒక ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ సెషన్ ఆన్ వర్కింగ్ విత్ చిల్డ్రన్ విత్ సివియర్ డిసెబిలిటీస్ మనం ఒకసారి చేద్దాం తర్వాత. బట్ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్ ఆర్ ది సేమ్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ వీ కెన్ గివ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్ బై డూయింగ్ ఇట్ డజన్ అండర్గో చేంజ్. మీరు డయాగ్నోస్టిక్ లేబుల్ మీద ప్లానింగ్ చేయడం రాదమ్మా, యూ హ్యావ్ టు రియలీ మేక్ ష్యూర్ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ద కరెంట్ లెవెల్స్ ఇన్ హ్యాండ్, దెన్ ప్లానింగ్ ఈస్ అ పాసిబిలిటీ. కొంతమంది నోట్లో పెట్టితే అట్లనే మిగుతాడు, చూయింగ్ లేదు అంటే చూయింగ్ బికమ్స్ యువర్ ట్రైనింగ్ గోల్, రైట్? కూర్చుంటాడు, నిలబడలేదు, ఏమని చేయలే ఇస్తే పట్టుకోలేదు అంటే హోల్డింగ్ విత్ హ్యాండ్స్ బికమ్స్ యువర్ ఫోకస్ ఫర్ ట్రైనింగ్. So we have to look at activity deficit and then we have to work towards it. We can exclusively have a session. Good question. I know it's not easy to work with that group. Very difficult to work. We'll do it. Yeah?
Classroom
arrangement, seating position, gurinchi evaru adiginarama. The home learning gurinchi workshop ani anukuntanu nenu. Classroom arrangement also can change depending upon activity. Floor time ante andaru circle ga kurchi untaru class lo. Academics ante two tables together or one big regular school jaise classroom cheyagalaru meeru. Classroom arrangement in the regular school means the child will fit into a regular school arrangement. Based on activity, classroom arrangement will change. Yes.
For ADHD,
more than assessment, better.
Assessment better for training in special education.
What is the meaning of that? I don't understand. Okay, activity ADHD or no ADHD, attention deficit only ani chuste, you have to keep track of andarikamma manam kuda attention manam eppudu isthunnam manaki ishtamaina activity ante and manaku ekku attention isthamu ishtam ledhu gaani cheyalsindi ani oka activity undante mana attention kuda change avutundi. So you have to give an activity to the student that the student likes to do. Ensepu chestunnadu adi meeru oka matrix undi table laga chesi pettali meeru given activity chosen activity adi pettukovali ichinappudu time entha ensepu chestadu distract complete chesiyada ledha distract ayipoyinadu ante ela distract ayinadu window lo emo chusadu baita poyinadu. So you have to write, you have to fill the few intervals, you have to fill that. So you will get an idea of what activities keep him engaged, what activities he does half, or what activities, what distractions take him away. So it's a analysis. In analysis, dani kosam emi ready made battery ledu. We have to make rows and columns for that. There is a table for it. So here table ila untundi. Here all the activities are listed, all the activity you are going to give are listed. Here meer ichara babu teeskunnada, chosen activity or given activity, time taken, time starting, time ending, completed, not completed. Not completed ante enduku distract ayinadu, like that this will be written for all the activities. Then you have to look at the matrix, then you will see a pattern. What distract adi podinam cheyali madhyanam cheyali evening cheyali ee time lo attention ekkuva undi or attention deficit ekkuva undi ee time lo attention takkuva undi adi kuda ganapadtadi meeku ee activity lo attention ekkuva undi elanti distractions babu disturb avtadu adanni matrix lo vachestundamma. Very very neat matrix you will get. After that you are a teacher, you can plan accordingly. Idi excellent situation, maximum attention ikkada istunnadu, ilanti conditions lo manchiga chestunnadu babu, complete chestadu ani adi matrix lo meeku kanavadutadi. Those become your activities for teaching. We have to develop, there is no ready made ones for that. These are the side headings ipudu cheppinaru kada, those will be the side headings of the matrix. Good question. Yeah, this is the teachers face this as a big problem. Example of adaptations on articles for ADL requirement, intellectual disability kundadu. Cerebral palsy undante cerebral palsy ki adaptation untundi. Intellectually disabled article adaptation ekkuva undadamma, not much. Maybe fine motor skill manchiga ledante you give velcro shirts, idi hair clip pettukodam, the small small changes you can do. ఎందుకంటే చెయ్యి కాళ్ళు మంచిగా ఉంది కదా మన పిల్లలకి, ఎక్కువ మోటార్ డెఫిసిట్స్ లేదు కాబట్టి నాట్ మచ్ అడాప్టేషన్స్ ఫర్ దట్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్? టైమ్స్ అప్ నో రెడీ. Yeah. Well, thank you all so much. We'll meet again another time. Thank you, organizers, State Government of Andhra Pradesh and NIMH. Bye-bye.
All of you, see, I beg apology from the very beginning that I cannot speak in Telugu except some personal interaction. So kindly excuse me. And anyway, all of you are aware of your roles and responsibilities in this home-based programs for the children with intellectual and developmental disabilities. But what exactly we need to do, probably we are a bit confused as we are shifting the school to the home environment. Keeping that in mind, let us see what is our role as teacher, what we can do for the students when they are at home. As Jayanti Madam has already informed that whatever we are doing in the classroom, only we have to apply the same to the home environment. So in the school, we try to do the assessment, isn't it? So now the same thing we have to continue when we go for the visit for any kind of support we try to provide to the student with IDD. We have to first take the lead in assessing the students. And you see, when we are going to home and assessing the students, probably we cannot take a very long time. When we are trying to assess the students, we use various checklists in the school environment. But now, as we are going to visit home, we may not spend a lot of time. We may not spend a lot of time in assessment. So we may have to see what are the areas we have to focus on. And on those areas, we have to take the information from the parents. We have to observe the child's behavior at home. And on the basis of that, we do the assessment. So the major role we have: student assessment, ecological assessment, selection of goal, planning, demonstration, and evaluation. That usually we do at school setting also. Let us see what we do in student assessment. As we discussed, and as we are seeing that assessment using some specific checklist, many of you must be using functional assessment checklist, or you may be using basic MR, MDPS. These are the common checklists we use for assessing the children or the students with intellectual disability. But using such a huge checklist with so many areas, it may be difficult at home environment because we have to give the programming also, the objectives and the activities also we have to give in the same system. So we may have to quickly do the assessment of the student on personal, social, home management, academics, occupational and recreational activities. What activities we can take that all of us are aware of, but a few examples probably we can discuss. And you know, when we talk about ecological assessment, particularly when we are thinking about giving any planning to the students for their development, for their training, we also need to know the surrounding, what are the availability in the surrounding, what are the things available, and who are there to support. Because unlike school, unlike the school environment, we may not have the readily available materials with us. We may not have the chair table to teach. And rather in the home setting, we are getting a separate set of activities, separate set of social support system and different resources are available. So in order to give the plan the program for the students, we have to do the physical environment we need to assess at home, particularly in this lockdown situation. When in the lockdown situation, we talk about ecological assessment, we have to basically need to know what are the physical environment, physical structure of the home environment. Accordingly, we have to plan the activities. What is the social support system available? You know, there are families where this child may be a single child. In some families, we have extended family members, uncle, auntie, grandparents, all are available. In some families, only the siblings are available. So who can provide the support in this home environment? We need to make a thorough assessment of that, because we are going to involve all of them in the training activities of the students with ITT. And apart from that, we cannot get very hi-fi materials. In the school, you may be using the block, the plastic blocks which are available in the market. We may be using different kinds of soft toys, different kinds of balls, different kinds of rhyme books, maybe chip recorder, computer, so many things we have the availability in the school's setup. But all the things may or may not be available in this environment. Some of the items we may be getting more and some we are getting less. And we also have to see that what is the space available and who are coming forward to help in providing the resources in helping the child with difficulty. Okay, so when we are talking about assessment, on the basis of our assessment of the student, of the physical environment, the social environment, and the family resources, we are coming up with some goals, isn't it? So when we are talking about the goals, all of us are aware that we are using different domains like personal, social, academics, home management, recreational, all these domains. We are used to it when we are using various checklists. From this, we have to select the goals for a longer period of time, which I have skipped in this, as all of us know. But when we are giving the activities on the priority basis, we must select the activities from those goals which are derived from the assessment. This is a sample planning which we had given, and it is given in a single page, which is convenient for both the teachers as well as the parents to maintain it. If the student has a file at home also, then the parents also can keep. So as a sample, I had given some activities like brushing teeth, meaningful counting up to three, identification of two foods. These are the activities we have taken, and considering the present situation, we also have to teach some hygienic behavior to the children at home at the given situation. So one can be taken from that, washing hand. And all of us are aware that this virus is spreading through the unhygienic hand washing, and when we are putting it in the mouth, the nose, the eyes. So we must help these children to understand the importance of washing hands. But this level of children, basically I have taken a primary level of child for whom a hypothetical planning has been done. So for this child of primary level, it is definitely difficult to understand what is this coronavirus, how does it spread. But we can definitely, as part of good habit, we can teach
washing hands using soap. At least before, after food, morning when getting up, after doing any of the craft arts related activities, after going for play or gardening activities. So we must decide which are the activities require hand washing. And definitely we have to teach washing hands using soap before and after taking food. Okay. And here, tentatively, what are the materials we require? We can give which date we are visiting the family. We must give the date of evaluation, because after the stipulated period, we may have to go once again for observing the, assessing the progress of the child. And as you have seen, this is also some hypothetical activities are jotted down here. Yesterday, Shilpa Madam and Usha Madam has already covered various activities for engagement of the children during this lockdown period. So from the activities now also, we can pick up a few activities, and few activities in a sequential order, order of complexity I have taken, like taking head bath, dressing as per occasion, preparing breakfast snacks by reading or following instruction, making a shopping list. We'll discuss how it can be done at a later slide. Then home budgeting, filling up a form, stitching, mending, washing, ironing, talking to, you see, social behavior is completely restricted in this given situation. So when we reopen the school, or when the children will start going out, it will be a tough time for the children as well as the parents and the teachers to manage them. So we have to see how best we can maintain some of the social behavior of the children by encouraging them to talk to the friends, relatives by over phone, because that is very common now. Some of the people may be having the system or in the smartphone. We can go for video call, we can go for WhatsApp call, so that interaction can take place, which will at least maintain the social behavior apart from with the family members. And also we must encourage them to take the phone calls or talk to people and take the messages and passing the messages to the concerned person at home. Watching news, reading newspaper, checking the current affairs, these are some of the important areas which must be taught to the students at higher classes like secondary and pre-vocational level. Apart from that, drawing, painting, singing, dancing, gardening, physical exercises, yoga and health care. This last two, physical exercise and health care activities, are really important in this situation. We must find a place how we can accommodate these activities in our schedule when we'll be trying to give any kind of program on the basis of our assessment, which can make our children fit and which will help the children to maintain their physical health and avoid any kind of cough, cold and fever or any kind of related viral infection. And few activities, as you are seeing towards the end, like drawing, painting, singing, dancing, gardening, rapping, that probably will help the parents to understand what are the interest and aptitude of the students when they are at home. And that may help us in selecting the future vocation for the children when they'll be coming to the school or the vocational training centers, because all the children, irrespective of age, irrespective of the severity level, they are locked at home. So when they'll be coming, we must immediately find some activities for their future, for their career. So based on few activities which you can enhance, few more activities which will help us some hints that these children are having interest in this different area. Somebody may be good in fixing different puzzle. That may help us to understand that the children may be doing better in assembly board. Some may be showing interest in gardening. So we can think about horticulture. Backing, some can do the operating the computer. So some of the high functioning students may be able to operate the computer, use the computer, and they can be placed at a later stage in entering the data of the cases in some of the software companies. We can try to find some activities for them which can be really in those areas. Real intensive training can be given when they will come for the vocational activities. A part of that, you are finding that home budgeting and filling up of the forms. At filling up of the forms, you might have observed that when we are teaching the children, the students in the classroom, write your name in a given notebook. They are writing their name, they are writing the parents' name, they are writing the address, phone numbers, everything. But the similar thing when you are twisting a little and trying to give it in a form of any kind of form, they are helpless. They do not know what is to be done. So now probably we have the time and we have all the family members at home to give the support to the students. We can generate different types of forms, from simple to complex forms, where they have to fill up the names against the thing given name. They have to write the father's name, they have to write the address, they have to write the age, date of birth. So different details, we can make different forms and we try to give it to them. And another important area is we try to teach them money management, but we have to focus on home budgeting also. In home budgeting, now also we are purchasing the items. Earlier also we were purchasing the items. So those who are bit elder, secondary to pre-vocational level, we can try to give them some amount in their hand, maybe maximum of 200 per week. And every day when somebody, some family member, either the sibling or the father or any other family members will go to the nearby shop for purchasing anything, that time they'll be taking money from them and they'll be returning it back, whatever balance is there. In that, we may have to encourage the students that they have to give the date. Today is 8th July. So putting the date 8th July, they may have to write down sugar 20 rupees, tea powder 25 rupees, milk packet 25 rupees. So today's expenditure is this much. Every day they can do that, because we are teaching them addition, we are teaching them money concept. If required, we can give their calculator also. So like that, every day they have to write what is the expenditure and what is the balance. At the end of the week, we can fix a particular day, maybe Sunday. As Sunday is marked in red color in the calendar, they have to total what is the expenditure of that particular week in red color pen. Like that, after 4 months, they have to pick up all this red color amount and put it in one place, total it up, and say that write it in green color and mention that this is the total expenditure of this month. Out of 500, this is the expenditure, this is the balance, and balance will go to their own piggy bank. So when they are getting something, they'll definitely show the interest, and through that, sitting at home also there trying to see how they can budget, how can they plan, how can they learn addition, how can they learn subtraction, how can they make the transaction with the money. Similarly, we have to think about whatever is over at home, they have to make the shopping list for that. And very specifically, we have to encourage them to make any special dish at least once in a week. And those dishes, they have to make it by reading the instruction given either in the packet of that particular thing, or this can be written by any other family member, and a cooking book can be handed over to them. By seeing the dishes every week, they can prepare. That will help the students in maintaining the reading habit, comprehending what is read, and trying to act what they have read, and try to follow the instruction in preparation. So they are learning cooking, they are learning reading, they are learning comprehension. All these things at a stretch we are enhancing. One more important aspect I want to highlight, that particularly it is important for secondary and higher secondary, watching TV news, reading newspaper. I'm telling the current affairs. When they were going to the school, in the assembly, every day one student has to stand in the front and talk something. Now that is completely stopped. So basically they are not having that kind of facing the public. So now at least if they watch the TV news for some time and try to understand what it is coming, or they can read the headlines in the newspaper and try to tell what is the important, what they are thinking. It can be the price hike of the price, it can be the border issue, anything which comes in headline according to their interest, they need to copy it in any book, and they have to tell what they understood from that, because all our children are having the habit of watching TV. Instead of watching TV news, they try to watch the serial, the cartoon, the movies. So instead of that, we may have to make condition that every day you have to watch TV news, then you will be allowed to watch your favorite cartoon network. So through that, we are trying to develop comprehension, we are trying to develop reading habit through reading the newspaper, we are trying to develop writing habit. If we are telling them, you write whatever you feel is important for you in the newspaper, let them copy it also at initial stage, and we are also enhancing their memory. If you try it out today, maybe after 6 months you will find the difference in their comprehension, in their expression, both verbal as well as written expression, and the memory in remembering the various current affairs will also be enhanced, and that will keep them at peace with the current scenario. And all these activities, these are not the only activities. We have to list down a number of activities, and I'm sure that you have seen it yesterday. You see, for the small kids, we have to give the visual schedule, because they may not follow if we are giving any kind of schedule. And remember one thing, the school schedule is not same as the home schedule. It starts, home schedule starts when the children get up from the bed, and it ends when they go to the bed. So for the small kids up to the primary level or low functioning secondary level students, we may have to give the visual schedule like this. You can have a number of visual schedule. If you want to Google it, you can find. This is another visual schedule. You see, mostly we use the visual schedules for the children with autism and also with the children with intellectual and developmental disability. So by seeing the icons given site or seeing the pictures, they'll be able to follow what is to be done. And why it is important, let us come to that. Apart from the visual schedule, also we need to prepare the activity schedule for the students with IT. Those who are able to follow the minimum reading requirement is there, we can give, or along with the activities schedule, we can give small icons beside, for example, getting up from the bed. So there we can give the small icon and we'll give the time of doing all these activities and who will be helping them in doing, or they can do it by self. Apart from this, to the right side of this, we have to give the dates. Suppose we are starting this from tomorrow onwards. So from 9/7/2020 till the end of this month, 31/7/2020, we can give the boxes beside this. See, these are all the activities taken up from the home environment. Arranging for lunch, then we must give rest to the children, we must give various domestic or home management activities to them. We have to involve them in cooking irrespective of their gender, and we have to involve them in both indoor and outdoor games if feasible. Plus, we are giving the academic activities also to the students, and there definitely we have to have somebody, father, siblings, mother, one of them should be supporting them in the activities both in the morning and in the evening. And if possible, those who are high functioning, we can also insert some of the academic activities in the afternoon by not telling them it as academic. Like the home budgeting that is coming under functional academics, but that activity can be done during, after the lunch, during afternoon session, maybe with the support of their sibling or any other member who is of that age group. If not available, mother or father can also do, so that they are not thinking that we are trying to study something. You know, all of us are having that feeling that how long we can study, and this is more so for the students with intellectual disability. Why should we sit with the paper and pencil and pen and we study all these things with the books? So whomever you are asking, they'll say that we are happy watching TV at home. But in order to break that thing, we have to insert some interesting activities which the students will themselves so interest in doing. If you are giving some, prepare some snacks, and all are involved in the family in doing that, but our student will read the specific instruction which is given on the back side of the packet and try to read it and direct them. You take 1 cup of milk, add 4 spoons of sugar, mix custard powder in 1/2 cup of water, allow the milk to boil. So all this will be written with the picture, it will be shown, and the students will read it, and if he or she can direct the other family members who will be performing it, the feeling of self-satisfaction that I read it and I directed, I guided my parents, my mother to do the activity, that will give a different type of satisfaction. And there also we are trying to inculcate some of the academic activities which is unknowingly the student is learning. Reading, comprehension, measurement, all these things are taught by using this type of activities. So we must see how best we can do. And after doing all these things, we have to, as teacher, we have to definitely check the progress of the students. Either now the technology has been advanced so much that we are using online sitting at Secunderabad. We are able to interact with all of you who are sitting in Andhra someplace. So, if possible, we can go for some WhatsApp group or through phone calls. We have to take the feedback from the family members on a regular basis. What is happening to the programs given? If it is not at all possible because of the connectivity problem, then we can go for the alternate option, that is only personal visit after the specific period, maybe after 15 days or 1 month as per your schedule, which has been fixed by the coordinator of Samagra Shiksha. These are the basic things in home-based program. So apart from this assessment, planning the program, selection of the goal, the demonstration, how it is to be taught, using various teaching strategies, we have to plan how we can teach them, and we have to also give number of activities to the parents, and we give some sample activity schedule to the parents which may or may not be suitable for the home environment. So the parents or the family members can change it as per their convenience and as per the home environment. So we, for teaching anything, we have to prepare some teaching learning materials also. So that is also one of the responsibilities of the teachers who will be visiting. We may not provide the teaching learning materials to the parents or the family members to teach at home, but at least we can give the demonstration, and we can at least tell them to prepare the materials, what you have prepared for teaching various concepts to the children. Okay. So this is about basically, very briefly, the role of the teachers. Though the role of teacher is very responsible job, and it is the Herculean task. Sitting here, we are telling that these are the only jobs, but this job also takes a lot of time and lots of efforts on the part of the teachers. So now we have to coordinate with the family members in order to see how best the home training takes place in their respective home environment. So we must involve the family members in implementing the selected objectives, what we have selected on the basis of our assessment. All this need to be implemented in the home environment. Of course, we have to take the opinion of the parents in deciding or selecting the goals, because that is the major responsibility lies with the parents. What type of activities are really important for the students in the present situation, they know. But many a time, we may have to counsel the parents if they are not having the realistic goals. We have to see that how best we can set the realistic goals and objectives for our students with IDP. And after selecting the objectives, we must interact in close proximity with the family members, not only the parents, but also the siblings, the grandparents, if available, the uncle, aunts, relatives, whoever is staying, whoever is participating in our activity. We have to involve all of them. So the schedule we had given may or may not be applicable. So we have to see and give respect to the parents for scheduling the aspect, the activities as per their respective home environment. And monitoring or closely supervising different activities which are given to the students at home for development in different domains. And all this implementation is only possible when appropriate techniques will be used and appropriate materials will be used in teaching or transacting the instruction to the students, which teachers have to encourage the parents and teachers have to educate the parents how the techniques and the materials to be used. And most important is reinforcing the desired behavior of the student in the particular scenario. When the parents are given all the freedom in deciding the activities for their own work at home, they must decide what is to be taught, what is to be taught and why is it essential for my child. Why should I teach my child dressing skill? Many a time when the children were coming to the school, most of the personal skills are done by the mother because mother wants to do it fast. Now you see, we get an opportunity where we are giving our children enough space for learning. So now that has to be decided. They have to decide, should we teach dressing skill to our children? Should we teach maintaining hygiene? And why should I teach maintaining hygiene? Many a time in some high socioeconomic status people, they use the spoon since it is convenient and they are not insisting the children to wash the hands. But in the particular scenario, it is very, very essential to help the children to learn hand hygiene, how to wash the hands for a particular period of time. So in that case, we have to encourage them at least the snacks they should eat using hand. When they are using hand, naturally they have to maintain neatness in the hand, and for that they have to clean the hand using the soap. So the parents must know what I should teach and why is it essential. They should know I must teach hand washing to my child, and it is essential because we can avoid the virus by washing the hand repeatedly and washing the hand, cleaning the hand, because unknowingly many a time we touch different parts of the face and that itself will be a risky factor for the children as well as the family members. So keeping the situation in mind, we have to decide what is to be taught. That the parents should take the decision and when it should be taught. Whatever activity we are selecting for the teaching, we must see when it should be taught. If we are teaching the dressing skill in the night, will it have any meaning? Rather, we must teach brushing, dressing. Even brushing can be taught in the night, but dressing skill has to be taught in the morning hours only. When they'll take bath, after that they get dressed. And maybe in the evening they have a proper wash and dress. So we must decide whatever activity is selected, when it has to be taught and where. Now you see, when we do the ecological assessment, usually we have to assess the entire community. But keeping in mind the present scenario of lockdown situation, we cannot take the community in our hand. We have to teach everything at home only. So where it has to be taught. For example, we are teaching the children to do physical exercise or yoga. Where it has to be taught. Some outdoor things, because the physical activity also are important. We cannot make the children always in front of the TV, or we cannot make them sit, read, write, or stand in the kitchen and do some activities. Some of the physical activities are to be involved in the process. So where it has to be done? If we have a terrace, we can think about terrace when we are teaching physical exercise. Or playing badminton, we can think about our lane also, if it is safe. Or we have to, if we do not have any space, we have to think about the room where we are living. We have to clean it and we have to use that for our physical exercise also in making involvement of the students. And we are getting a golden opportunity now, because not only the mothers, but the father, the siblings, or all are at home now. And in earlier situation, we were getting wonderful plea that father has gone to his job, so he is not available, he cannot take care. Siblings are going for their academic activities, college, school, wherever they go, and they have homework they cannot do. But now the situation is so that all are at home. So we can take it as an opportunity and see that whenever, whoever is free, we have to involve them in teaching various activities to the student with IDD. And how strategies madam has already told. So using different strategies they have to teach, which needs to be explained thoroughly to the family members. So this is again a brief sample where you can see what is to be taught during exercise, where it is terrace, when 7 a.m. in the morning, it cannot be after lunch definitely, with whom it can be, with sibling, and how watching the sibling through modeling or any other strategy, what has already been explained to you, we have to think. Like this, we have to see that how best we can give different activities, and the parents or the family members are responsible to make this type of schedule by involving all the family members in the teaching learning process of the children with intellectual disability. Through this, we are also trying to inculcate the belongingness to the family. We are also trying to inculcate in the siblings how to take responsibility, which we found a bit tough in earlier times when there was no lockdown situation. So probably we can take this as an opportunity to help our children with IDD. And while scheduling the activities, we have to maintain a proper balance of different activities in order to sustain the interest and energy level of the students. Many a time we think that now the school is closed, so students are not getting an opportunity to learn reading, writing, arithmetic skills. So let us impose all this reading, writing, arithmetic throughout the day. Let them sit and let them learn everything at a goal. If we are thinking in that manner, probably the children will not learn anything. They may educate. So we have to have proper balance of different activities, what we are selecting, along with the academic, along with the personal skill. We also have to give them some resting time, some break we have to give. We also have to see that how different sets of activities we are selecting for our children based on their age, based on the ability, and based on different associated conditions. And close monitoring or supervision of the student activities is very, very essential. Very specifically, when we are giving them some academic activities, we are giving them some fire cooking activities which have some risky factors. So we must see why the supervision is essential. You see, many times it so happens. I'll give a very simple example. If we'll ask the child to write your name, we allow the child to write the name in a complete one page. 10 times you write your name. We must be remembering our childhood. When we do some spelling mistake, our teachers used to say, write it 5 times, write it 10 times. Isn't it? So like this, for giving practice, we give them to write 10 times the name of the child. For example, we are teaching the student's name as Rajesh, R-A-J-E-S-H. So after 2-3 line of copying, the student will go to the fourth line where he will write R-A-J-S-H. He will be missed, and that R-A-J-S-H will continue for the remaining page or remaining 6-7 lines. So what will happen? The student has learned something wrong. When the student has learned something wrong because of lack of supervision or lack of proper monitoring, that wrong thing will be in the mind. Now when we are really teaching the proper thing to the student, we have to make the child first unlearn what he has already learned, and then we have to go for the correcting. So that will take more than the time what we can spend for supervising the children. You see, now I'm trying to give a few activities. As I told that, we can take all these activities and you can go on adding the activities. You will get these activities from your Google search also. Identify the colors. This is for the small children, for small children and the with older children also few activities are there. You see, here we can teach the students color matching, then the fine motor skill, and until and unless they concentrate, probably they cannot clip it to the board which is given. Here again, when the child is starting the writing, we can help in picking up one by one and putting it another ball or another box. We can teach color in that. We can develop the fine motor skills in the student using this. And maybe we can use all these blocks for adding. When the color matching is there, color identification is there, we must allow to see that read various things. This is an activity where the student has to color as per it is written on the balloons or the cup or the ball. See, this is the simple activity where you have to give some color papers. We must be throwing many papers, many of the waste items we can use, make the circle in that and help the students in punching it. Maybe at the higher level of primary class we can teach. And in these are the fine products also, though very simple activity. They have to only make single punch on the circle given. With that, they are making something. You can tie a thread and it can be used as book marker. So whatever our students have done with this, that will be useful for their siblings or the parents. That will give again some self-satisfaction. And they'll be using a simple hand tool, punching. They will learn that this is called a single punch, and this is the way we can use. If we are using and making, we can make the hole in the single using the single punch. And for tying different important papers, we can use this and tie it in a thread. see for the small kids, we can teach this. This will develop the finger grips. They have to take up and they have to press, and we can probably use the glue. You give the tube to the student where they'll apply glue on the marked places on the curve, and they have to fix all the buttons. Missing numbers. Missing numbers, then making the words, jumble letters to make the word. Small kids art and craft activities we can give at home. This can be also, if not play, we can use some color and with simple atta. What is it called? Wheat flour, pindi. This can be used by adding some color to the water. Paper boats, this is rainy season, they can make the boat and enjoy when there is waterlogging. Though it's not good, but waterlogging, they can leave the boat, it will go. You see, when we are trying to teach some academic skills, we need to get their attention. We need to develop proper observation skills in them. So we have to give some activity where they have to thoroughly observe the things which are given to them, and that will help them in developing the sitting tolerance as well as observing when we are trying to give some important topic to them. So let them find out where these items are. Find the difference. So some of these activities, it is not academic activity, but definitely it will help in focusing. Some of the indoor games we can give, where again they have to concentrate, otherwise the partner will get the points. Ludo. It will help in color, it will help in counting, it will help in also the fine motor, because the finger has to move the coins. Snake and ladder. Here we can teach the number concept, we are teaching addition, we are teaching subtraction, and it is a fun game for the children. Like this, we need to find out different activities for the students where they will not feel that we are only sitting and doing academics as per the instruction. We must give such activities where the students would say that you must give more such activities. We are interested to do this. And from this also, we can find out where they are showing more interest. Apart from that, you can give gardening, which will lead to horticulture later on. And we must remember that very specifically when we are trying to help the parents in helping their students or children at home, how to reinforce the behavior. I'm sure reinforcement is covered. I'm not going to talk about reinforcement. But for the younger children, we can give primary and social reinforcement. Whereas for the higher age group, we have to skip the primary reinforcers. We have to give social reinforcement and token economy. Token economy is such a system which helps in money transaction at a later stage. So we must see, as I told you in the beginning, we had given some activity schedule. In that activity schedule, the students have to give the tick mark what they have done. Initially, it will be supported by one of the family members, but later on, as they are progressing, we have to see that they themselves should be encouraged to give the tick mark. And at the end of the day, out of 20 activities, they will be counting how many they have done. Accordingly, we can decide how many points we can give to them. And for the points, we have to give the different kind of reinforcers. See, for example, 20 points. The student can be allowed to watch cartoon, which the student likes. For 15 points, play the favorite game, even in the smartphone. For 10 points, talking to the friend over phone, 5 points, one candy, like that. Depending on the interest of the student, we have to decide what kind of reinforcers can be attached to the points they are gaining. Okay? And if they want to keep the points for 1 week, 15 days, so through that, we are trying to help them how to wait for the benefits to get. Like, we have to wait for 1 month for getting our salary, 30 days. Sometimes some of us have to wait for 3 months, 4 months for getting the salary. So we must teach our student also that they have to wait for quite a long time also in order to receive any kind of reinforcers or any kind of pleasant event. So that is very important. This can be thought through token economy. At the end, I can say that home-based program for our children necessitates coordinated efforts of both the teachers and the family members. And we must acknowledge here the parents as the managers and the teachers as the guide and facilitator. Through combination of different activities, different teaching learning materials, proper scheduling, proper teaching methods and techniques, really we can help the children to develop and help the children to engage at home along with the proper development, what was happening even in the school, and then be ready when the student schools will reopen for them. Thank you so much. Any question?
Thank you, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can. I can hear. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you so much, ma'am. You have covered extensively what kind of activities can be given at home and what role parents and teachers can assume during this particular time. And we have few questions. Before taking up the questions, I would like to make general announcements that, dear participants, we have kept the feedback link in the chat box. Please click the feedback link. We have kept the feedback link in the chat box for the participants, so they can click it to give their feedback. We will also send this link to your emails. You can raise your hand and we will unmute you and you can ask the question. Rahul, please see if they are raising their hands and whom to unmute. Meanwhile, we'll take up the question, ma'am. Of course, this is not very specifically related to your career.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, Silpa, where is my phone? I can't hear. Where is Rahul?
And can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can hear. Yeah. Yeah, tell.
Hello?
Yes, yes. There is some problem in the audio. Yes, you can tell.
Yeah. The type of assessments to be carried out for children with learning disabilities in the inclusive setting. This is one question. Okay. And the second question is relevant to the topic, that is, many parents say that we cannot teach, they don't listen to us when we teach. What should we do?
That's what I told. When we are making the children sit and make them do the activities, academic activities, they don't like. So when we are trying to start our teaching, we have to develop rapport with them. Even the parents have to develop rapport with them. And maybe we have to give the they are so used to the TV watching and so many other things which they are not doing earlier. So we have to start with different activities. Come, let us play this game now. So we have to find out what is their interest. I have given so many activities. Out of all these activities, I don't think I had given any academic activity as such. Most of the activities were activity only, not making the children sit and read and write and do anything else. Allow the children first to watch the TV if they want, and tell them, if you are watching TV, at least you have to explain to me what you have watched for 2 minutes. Then you allow the student, we'll have some fun game depending on the age of the student. We may have some painting, drawing activity, and it can be for also other siblings if they're there at home. So we have to make a proper balance with the activities. If the students are not learning the academics now, we must see that we are starting with different, we must start with different activities. It can be arts and craft activities, it can be indoor games, it can be outdoor games, it can be gardening activity, it can be preparing some gift item, it can be making some special dish on different occasion. Depending on the interest of the student, we have to start the activity. Definitely not with the academics, what very specifically it is done in the school. So the school schedule and home schedule are to be totally different. Yes. Am I making some sense? Not audible. Am I audible?
You are audible.
Yeah.
You are audible, ma'am. Yeah. I think participants, you have to, as likely madam has said, that the activities which are selected has to be of the interest of the children. And in order to start initially, it's better to select activities which are non-academic. What we have given a lot of examples, ma'am has explained. So please try and see. Parents might tell, ante vaalle general ga alane cheptaru chaala mandi. కాని మనము వాళ్ళకి చెప్పేటప్పుడు వాళ్ళతో మాట్లాడేటప్పుడు ఈ యాక్టివిటీ చేసి చూడండి, ఈ యాక్టివిటీ ట్రై చేసి చూడండి అని వీ హ్యావ్ టు పర్సుయేట్ దెమ్ అండ్ ఆస్క్ దెమ్ టు ట్రై అవుట్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ అండ్ లైక్ వీ హ్యావ్ ఆల్రెడీ ఎంఫసైజ్డ్ ఇన్ అవర్ యెస్టర్డేస్ ప్రెజెంటేషన్ ప్లీజ్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ద వెల్ సిబ్లింగ్స్ ఆల్సో వెల్ సిబ్లింగ్స్ ని ఇన్వాల్వ్ చేయడం కూడా చాలా ఇంపార్టెంట్ So by that, probably, you know, children can be engaged nicely at home. Rahul, can you see if there is anybody raising the hand and can we unmute? And also, ma'am, we have Dr. Chandrika with us. In the beginning, she was having some other meetings, so she couldn't join in the beginning. But now we do have her with us. May I request Dr. Chandrika, madam, to please say a few words addressing the participants and regarding the program, as today is our last day of the 3 days online program. Chandrika, ma'am, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you, Shilpa. At the outset, I should thank all the dignitaries who have given their valuable words and suggestions to our artists regarding every topic that are included in this webinar. And mostly I want to say that what all they have given, they have enlightened the artists in a manner where the RP can do their own activities instead of depending upon some work groups or any other thing. They are given a chance to make them understand and realize what they have to do actually. And the teaching strategies and other learning styles for MR children was wonderful, madam. Many of the what is called the dignitaries who have given their good messages, that I have seen a little bit there. you are giving the more prominence and a value to a MR child, and how we have to tackle the child and how to treat the child, and in what manner we can give some good knowledge or information to make them to have learn some cultural skills where they can do their own work in a systematic manner. And I'm very much thankful to Shilpa and their team members who have come all the way to support us, some of the teachers, and give a good online training program. And I hope it is very much useful to all our RPs that are related to MR. And another most important thing, I have to thank my state project director, Shilpa sir, and he is the commissioner of school education. And he has given the time for having this particular training program, and he is having a lot of passion towards the particular CWS children. So he is much interested to create some more programs, especially for VI and Kuchai and other also. He told us he will be in the meeting. Yeah. And another important thing which I heard earlier, at 2:30 and 3 o'clock, that Madam told us creating their own activity. There is nothing like something we have to take some from the book and reading and teaching. That is not the process for them. Because based on the disability, we have to create some activities, create some learning things, and also create some teaching styles to make the child realize himself what he is, and making or cope up him to work for himself. And once again, I thank you, Shilpa, for doing this perfect work and having a good understanding with Narasimha, because Narasimha is very much interested in doing all these activities, and he's taking a lot of interest also to support us CWS children. Once again, my heartfelt thanks to all the team members and all the members. Thank you. Thank you, Shilpa.
Thank you. Thank you, madam. I would like to also, although it's an in-house thing for us, but I would like to thank Dr. Nivedita Patnaik and Dr. Jayanti, madam, who have taken a lot of efforts and agreed to deliver these lectures in a very short notice. Thank you, Jayanti, ma'am. And thank you, Nivedita, madam. And I also thank Narasimha for coordinating because, madam, without his support, probably it would not have been possible. I think there were many questions, like from day one, day two, and day three. We have seen, madam, that many of the RPs were having a lot of questions regarding the behavioral aspects, the behavioral issues, how to manage behavioral issues among children with intellectual disabilities. So, and also regarding therapeutic aspects also. So because it was a 3-day program and we were strictly concentrating on the educational aspects, we have not covered anything related to that. Probably in future, if time permits and if everything goes on well, we can have a separate webinar for that. Yes. And I would request all the participants that the feedback form is given to you in the chat box, and if you click on this, on that it will open. In case if it is not opening, do not worry, all of you will receive the feedback form in your registered email ID, okay, by tomorrow. And all the PowerPoints also we will be sharing to you after some time, after we compile them and all, and you will be receiving the e-certificates within 10 working days after you submit the feedback form. So while you are submitting your feedback form, ensure that you are writing your name correctly and your RCI number correctly, because once we give, and again, no changes can be done in that. So please make sure that you type your name and RCI number correctly.
Thank you, Shilpa. Thank you very much.
Yeah. So, you're
closing it, Shilpa?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, we are closing it now. And you can take the exit button and the webinar will be ended.
Thank you
so much for having this program for IERTs. Andhra Pradesh State Government. I must. So I'm